Yeah, machsan be good. Vetziod yad shnia. So this is the, yeah, we hit it. Shalom, everybody. One time found out there was a thrift store here in the area where I happen to be staying right now. So it's a beautiful park there. Israel is covered in parks for children. Like, there's always children playing in the park. It's amazing. It's fantastic. Parks are not places where bad people go to do bad things. But somewhere close to here is the thrift store. If I recall, it's been, I don't know, maybe a year since I passed by it. So I'm going to go try and check it out and see what's there. Maybe we'll enjoy something. All right. See you there. Bye. I'm going to try and find my way first. I feel like I'm in the zone. I feel like I see a collection box. So that's maybe a hint. It's so familiar yet. Oh, there's lots of loads. You can see now there is a pile. There's a big sharing culture in Israel, which is really good and really bad. The really good part is that people are conscious that when they don't want something, you know, give it away, don't throw it away. They use things until they're done. Oh, this is really cute. Oh my gosh. Here, let me show you. It doesn't have a stain, which is the problem. People use things until they're done, until they're beaten to the ground. See, already there's a huge stain here. This isn't fabric I would buy for myself because it's like polyester and annoying. There's the nice crepe outside, but inside it's that super thick lining that's very commonly used here. It's cheap and it's heavy and it's annoying. Size 4 here, that's what goes on here. It's a 1, 2, 3, 4, that's it. It's very blunt. It's your grain if it doesn't too bad. There's no petite, there's no tall, there's none of that. Something fell in someone's lap. This looks like, to me, my untrained eye, but kind of trained because it's happened to me, vinegar from a salad, and that's why it's splashed up. I was gonna suggest we do a flip, like cut it off and make it into a blouse. Even though this pattern is quite pretty, it feels bad on the skin and it's hot. It's just bad. I just don't think it's worth it. We're gonna have to keep looking. We'll find something. All right, don't give up hope. We can do this, people. Let's see. There's more stuff in the pile also. And so this is what happens. I think I interrupted myself. Basically, people wear things into the ground. So if they do donate it, it usually is beyond the beyond, which puts extra, it doesn't mean you can't thrift flip here. It's actually really still sustainable and important practice, but it means you have to be strategic in how you thrift flip. So first of all, you have to, anywhere in the world, you have to check what you're getting. And there is gonna involve some fabric manipulation. Like here is a super great seersucker shirt. It looks fantastic, I'll show you. But because it's been outside, I don't even maybe it came this way. But these sleeves are atrocious. So could you wash this? Maybe. Is it worth the water and detergent effort? Maybe not. And so you start to get really strategic about how to thrift. Okay, so getting back to my original point. People are really into sharing here, right? So, oh my gosh, look at these sweat stains. Poor lady. Ooh, here's some corduroy. It makes me think of Best Dressed. I may shed a little tear because of her absence. I wonder where the heck she is. I saw her post in her Poshmark. Maybe she's still out there looking. So this is kind of a cool, I think she would get this. Here's another thing, because it's cheap. This is a nice corduroy. It's in good shape. What's the problem? It's faded, because the UV rays here are something else. A combined cheap processing of fabric. Combine it with the heat, with the sun, it's gone, right? So people hang things on the line. There's even on the wash tags, there's a warning not to hang things on the line for very long. This is 90% polyamide and 10% lycra. It's very interesting because usually they don't tend to fade. Fabrics tend to hold their color here more than cottons and linens, but apparently this is going to be an exception. This fabric is just, it's cute, but it's not worth it. So there's a lot of that, kind of deciding based on what you find. So what happens, people, because it's a sharing economy, people wear things into the ground and then they don't throw them away, even if they are beyond the beyond. Instead of throwing them away, they donate them, which is great. You could say that's super important. What happens is, you can see behind me, there's a donation box. Do people use a donation box? No, they do not. You could have all the signs in the world. People advertise, like these secondhand shops advertise, please be kind and use our donation boxes appropriately so that we can care for your donations. They don't. So people, what they do is, here and so many other places, all over the street, it doesn't even have to be at a secondhand site. It can be like even on Dipsy dumpsters outside people's apartment buildings. People set out things that they think look good, you know, that are, they don't personally don't want, they're done with, but they don't want to just throw it in the trash. So they put it next to the trash, on top of the trash, or like this, right on the sidewalk or in the street, whatever. This is the parking lot. So it's really taking up a parking space here. That's how much it's here. It's actually the size of a tiny car. It's almost the same size as the white car parked next to it. People do that so that people who need it don't have to pay at the thrift store, which, you know, in fairness, paying 5 shekel, which amounts to about, you know, $2.25, it's totally worth it because they wash it, they check for repair needs. They, ooh, disco shirt. I remember when these were in fashion. Why do people do this? Because they want to cut out the middleman so somebody who's in need can just walk up and take what they need. That's the idea. That's the theory behind it. But the fact is that, like I have told you before, cats own Israel from H&M. Ooh, fancy pants. It might be a throwback from our time in Egypt, but in any event, cats own Israel. So what does that mean? Oh, and a lot of people, because of religious reasons, but also not religious reasons. I love this little spring dress with the hearts on it. Don't you love this? I love this. So even though it's a child's dress, I'm going to try and do something with it. Maybe make some kind of corset. I don't know, but I love this. This is from Kiwi. What people do is leave things on the street so that, you know, to cut out the middleman. But the problem is the cats are the middle, become the middleman, and they spray the stuff because of different people being opposed to spaying and neutering on principle or whatever, then, which is a stupid, I'm sorry, but it's a stupid principle. So what they do is they don't spray and neuter, they feed the cats like enormous, like my neighbor with, you know, Wasili, the kitty kitty I told you about. So Kili Willy is actually, I thought he was just one of a pack of cats who ate from my neighbor who sets out food diligently every single day, dutifully. And in fact, no, she has a personal relationship with each of these cats. I underestimated. My hands wet, probably from a cat. So not a bunch, like there's not a lot of dog action. So people don't like, their dogs don't pee on this stuff. But like this is another kind of cute piece. It's got the nice sparkle, kind of make an evening top or whatever, cover up. But the problem is it's so acrylic. If you could feel this, you would think it was like shrink wrap from a package. It's so disgusting. So there's a combination of problems, right? Super cheap fabrics. So talk about fast fashion. There's a lot of fast fashion here. And because the prices for the fast fashion are in Israel are super high, even though it's not great quality stuff, people resort to much financially cheaper places. Not just quality cheaper, but financially cheaper places like AliExpress and Shein. And so people send away for that stuff. It's very cheap, but it also puts a harder burden on the environment, right? And these are not poor people. I know that there's a big conversation on the internet about, well, people who have no choice financially. Here, people, some people can afford better, but it's no better. What's available is no better. Some of it is a scarcity issue. It's not, and it's not because people couldn't. It's the importers really have a lockdown on what comes in the country, and I'm talking about raw materials. So that handicaps the garment industry, and it just kind of rolls downhill. The big problem is, like I said, people put things out trying to be kind and generous so that people who are in need can just help themselves, but the cats get to it first, it gets ruined, and then nobody can have it. So that's really a super big shame, but it is very typical. I want to show you this. This is like a little bit long john material. It's like a waffle weave. And it feels pretty warm, too warm for Israel. But if it's not stained, I think I like it. I love this color, yellow, kind of butterscotchy mustard. I don't know, I really like it a lot. My mother told me when I was little that it looks bad on me, so of course now I love it forever. The neckline is pretty dirty, it's pretty dingy. I don't see too much wrong with it. I'm gonna take a closer inspection when I put down the camera, but it just mainly, the only thing that looks wrong with it is it looks like it needs a good wash. That might be the problem. Maybe the person who had it just got bored of it. That's the nicer thing too about children's clothes, is thrifting children's clothes, even if they don't fit you. First of all, there are big children. All children are not tiny. So there is a little bit of a spread. But children tend to outgrow their clothes, so they're in better condition. And also, clothing manufacturers for children, this is like a religious kid's shirt, you can tell. This is like a standard, but it's been washed so many times. It's actually quite good quality. But the collar is toast. That's why it's called Manhattan since 1857. I don't know if I believe it, but in any event, the quality of the fabric is not bad. This is like really good pressing fabric. This is what I would use it for, is to iron in order to not ruin my clothes. I already have one, so I'm not gonna take this one. If I have a very nice, solid piece of smooth cotton fabric, I just use it as my pressing cloth. Everything out here is pretty junk. We'll see. Let's go inside and see what's in there. Oh, the door is locked. Ooh. So have you ever seen this guy? Like, I don't know. I wonder what you think of this. I always see this. This is a very common symbol also in America. I don't know if it's to see it like a Arnold Schwarzenegger strong guy flexing his cobras here, or if it's an actual cobra, like with the eyes there and the mouth. I don't know. What do you think? Does it look like a snake to you? Or I think this is like a blue and gold dress type controversy. Is this an Iron Man, a muscle man? Or is this a cobra? Let's see what's in here. Maybe somebody. And this is, some people are thoughtful enough. This was one big chesty lady. So that's like a triple D there. Ooh, boots. Let's see. My mother also told me never to wear boots because of the Holocaust. Like, not boots. I can wear boots. It's just not wear other people's boots. Not wearing other people's shoes, because of the Holocaust. They would make them put their shoes in a pile and say, now remember your number or whatever, so you can come back and get your shoes afterward. And then they would, I hate to get deep and heavy right now, but I mean, we're in Israel, I'm sure you're expecting no less. They would tell the, and when I say they, I mean the Nazi, Yamach Shemam, they would say, you know, remember your number, so you can claim your claim tag, so to speak, sort of like at the roller rink. And then they were gonna go in the gas chamber, so there was never gonna be claiming back the shoes. That freaked my mother out. I was like, never. I mean, my mother is the queen of thrifting, and she taught me about like fabrics and different qualities. So we would go to all the really fancy neighborhoods and go to the thrift stores there. The states have to take their stuff somewhere. We would go, and she would just teach me, like, this is this. She's really great at it. But one thing she always said, like, never wear someone else's shoes. So it kind of turns that whole thing about walking a mile in someone else's shoes.